Good morning. Good morning. God bless you. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Welcome to Destiny Church. Hallelujah. Good morning. Good morning. Come on into the sanctuary. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning. God bless you. Welcome. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful for today. Thank you, Lord. Good morning and God bless you. Welcome. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Welcome, welcome. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Facebook. Good morning, YouTube. Good morning, freeconferencecall.com. Good morning, Church Online. Good morning. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Good morning, good morning. God bless you. We see you out there. Welcome, welcome. Good morning, good morning. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. Good morning. God bless you. Welcome. Go call somebody, text somebody, holler in the other room, tell them, come on, we worshiping here this morning at Destiny Church. Hallelujah. I'm grateful. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity. Come on, let's praise him. Praise him. He died, was buried, and rose again for our sins. We're grateful. Thank you, Lord. Glory to his name. Thank you, Lord. He's so good to us. Come on, let's praise him. Praise him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, good morning and God bless you. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Destiny Church. Happy Resurrection Sunday. We are so thankful that the Lord has allowed us this opportunity to join in together and worship Him in spirit and in truth. We're thankful to God that He's allowed you to join with us today on this Resurrection Easter Sunday morning. And we just praise God for each and every one of you. And listen, if this is your first time worshiping with us, welcome. You are our special guest. We want you just to sit back, relax, and allow the Holy Spirit to move however it's going to move in your life. And so we just welcome you to Destiny Church. And so listen, I want to start off our worship experience by reading a passage of scripture from the 66th Psalm, Psalm 66, is where we'll find our scripture reading for this morning. And this is what it says, reading from the New International Version. It says, "Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of His name. Make His praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praises to you. They sing the praises of your name. Come and see what God has done, His awesome deeds for mankind. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the waters on foot. Come, let us rejoice in Him. He rules forever by His power. His eyes watch the nations, let the rebellious rise up against Him. Praise our God, all people. Let the sound of His praise be heard. He has preserved our lives and kept our feet from slipping. For You, God, tested us. You refined us like silver. You brought us into prison and laid burdens on our backs. You let people ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, but You brought us to a place, come on somebody, of abundance. I will come to Your temple with burnt offerings and fulfill my vows to You. Vows my lips promised and my mouth spoke when I was in trouble. I will sacrifice fat animals to You and offerings of rams. I will offer bulls and goats. Come in here, all you who fear God, let me tell you what He has done for me. I cried out to Him with my mouth. His praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But God has surely listened and has heard my prayer. Praise be to God who has not rejected my prayer or withheld His love from me." Amen, amen. I have read for you the 66th Psalm in its entirety. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the application of His holy and righteous word. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Our Father and our God, how we thank You for this day. We thank You for being so good and gracious to us to allow us to see it. Father, we recognize You didn't have to do it, but You did. You woke us up this morning, got us going on our way, and for that, we want to tell You thank You on this Easter Resurrection Sunday. Jesus, thank You for dying on the cross. Thank You for being buried, but thank You even more so for rising up again with all power that we might all rise as well, oh God. And so we thank You, Jesus, for Your sacrifice. And I pray, oh God, that You bless each and every individual under the sound of my voice. Forgive us of our sins. Wipe our slates clean. Thank You for giving us another chance. We glorify Your holy and righteous name today, Lord. And we pray, God, that we'd have such an amazing experience with You that by the end of the service, we know for sure it was You and You alone. And God, we also pray that You bless today's offering, that it may be used for the upkeep of our kingdom here on earth. Please bless the gift and the giver, oh God. And Father, we're praying that You would please expand our territory so much so that our cups runneth over and we can be a blessing to somebody else. Father, we want to tell You thank You in advance for victory. And we pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Together in love, we say amen, amen, and praise God. Well, good morning again, my friends, and God bless you. Welcome to Destiny Church here in Waldorf, Maryland. We are so excited and honored that the Lord has allowed us to join together and worship Him in spirit and in truth. We are excited that He's allowed you to come worship with us today. No, we still can't get into the sanctuary, but we are bringing the sanctuary to you through technology, and we just thank God for that. You know, I often think if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? He is on our side at all times. And so we are just so thankful to God. And listen, again, I wanted to welcome you. If this is your first time, your fifth time, your 100th time joining with us, welcome. But if this is your first time, again, you are a special guest. And so we want you to sit back, relax, and pray. And we pray that God blesses you in a mighty way through this service. And listen, if you want to get more information about our church, you can go look for us at our at our website, which is www.destinychurchmd.org. That's destinychurchmd.org. There you can find out more information about our church family, about me and our family. And we pray that you will stay connected with us. And so go check out our website, which is destinychurchmd.org. But also, if you'd like to send in a prayer request or a praise report, and I just want to thank each and every one of you who send in your prayer requests and praise reports. We are a praying church. And so it's our goal to turn prayer requests into praise reports. And so listen, if you want to send in a prayer request or a praise report, or you need some counseling or mentorship, or you want to reach out to me, listen, email us. Email me at prayerbuilds@gmail.com. That's prayerbuilds, B-U-I-L-D-S, at gmail.com. There you can send in your prayer requests, your praise reports, or if you need counseling or mentorship or anything, just email me at prayerbuilds@gmail.com. But also, listen, if you want to stay in the loop about what's going on here at Destiny Church, all you got to do is text the word loop, L-O-O-P, to 240-377-0811. That's 240-377-0811. If you text the word loop to that phone number, 240-377-0811, it'll connect you to our text message and email service, and there you can get information or basically stay in the loop about what's going on at Destiny Church. We send out information about what we're doing, throughout the week. And we also, from time to time, send out inspirational or motivational messages. And so connect with us by texting the word loop to 240-377-0811. In regards to some of the things that are going on at Destiny Church, one of the things we want to invite you to on Tuesday is Transformation Tuesdays, is what we call it. It's on at 6:30 p.m. every other Tuesday. We have our youth and young adult video chat with the pastor. So that'll actually be this coming Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. Eastern. We'll have a video chat with the pastor. And so our young people, our youth and young adults can connect with me via Zoom. And we talk about whatever's going on with them. We talk about things that are going on in the world, different things that they can connect to and want to talk about. But really what my goal is to impart a blessing upon each and every one of them, keeping them encouraged through this pandemic or anything else that's going on in their lives. So this Tuesday at 6:30 p.m., youth and young adults, join with us on our video chat with Pastor G, that's me, at 6:30 p.m. Eastern. But also every Tuesday at 7:30 p.m., Transformation Tuesday continues with our adult Bible study. And we have been having some awesome conversations. It's not just me sitting up there just talking and running my mouth. It's a dialogue. And so I just am blessed by the congregation and those visitors who come and join with us and share with us at Transformation Tuesday's Adult Bible Study. So listen, if you text the word loop to 240-377-0811, you can get the link to our Zoom Adult Bible Study on Transformation Tuesday. We want to see you there. We've been having an awesome time and we want you to join us. Amen. Amen. And again, I wanted to thank each and every one of you who are being obedient to the Lord in regards to tithes and offering. We just praise God for each and every one of you. And so if the Lord is placing it on your heart to give or donate through tithes and offerings or any form or fashion, you can do so two ways. The first way is through Givelify. You can either go to our website, click on online donations, and it'll take you directly to the Givelify app, or you can download the Givelify app on your smart device, and you just search for Destiny Church in Waldorf, Maryland. You'll see a picture of our logo, and I believe a small picture of myself, and there you can give however the Lord is leading you to give. So that's through the Givelify app. That's one way that you can give, but now we also have another way that that you can give as the Lord leads you to, and that's through Cash App. Our cash tag is $DestinyChurchWaldorf. That's $DestinyChurchWaldorf, all one word. And so however the Lord is leading you to give, you can do so through Cash App or through Givelify. And we thank and praise God for you. And so I think that's it as far as pastoral points for today. Again, happy Easter, happy Resurrection Sunday. We are just so excited that you are here to join with us and worship with us on today. And immediately following the message, we will partake in a communion, Holy Communion. And so listen, I want you to get your crackers or your bread or whatever it is you're going to use, and your juice or water, and get those ready, because immediately following the message, we will bless our elements and get right into Holy Communion, okay? So right now I want to play another selection, and then we're going to get right into the Word of God. So listen, go call somebody, go text somebody, holler in the other room, holler out the window, do what you got to do, but get them around your smart device, get them around the phone, the computer, whatever it is. We are worshiping God here at Destiny Church.
Protect them along the way. Wherever
Praise God. When the day is done, when everything is said and done, we pray that you can say, God did it. God did it. He sent his darling son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for each and every one of us. He died, he was crucified, he was buried, and he rose again with all power. And that's what we celebrate on today, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And because he got up, we can get up too. Amen? Amen. Praise God. Well, listen, it's preaching time. And so if you have your Bibles, I want you to turn with me to the book of 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. Wow. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11 is where we'll be shining our sermonic spotlight on today. And today I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. I normally read from the New International Version, but this morning I'm going to be reading from the New Living Translation. But whatever translation or version you have of 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, is fine. It's all the Word of God. And so listen, if you're struggling, if you have the Bible, your Bible, the book, and you are struggling to find 1 Corinthians, I want you to know that in every Bible comes a free gift called the Table of Contents. It's in front of the book. So all you have to do is go to the Table of Contents, look up 1 Corinthians. It's right there in the New Testament, 1 Corinthians. And then you will discover what page to turn to. And so we'll be looking at 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11. Don't be so deep that you can't use what's free. Amen? Amen. And so 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11 is where we'll be shining our sermonic spotlight. I'll be reading I'm actually going to read verses 4 through 11, but the entire verses 1 through 11 constitutes the context of what I'm about to preach. And so we will want you to highlight or mark verses 1 through 11, but I'll be reading verses 4 through 11 at this time from the New Living Translation. And this is what I want you to do. If you've got 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11, I want you to shout out in a loud voice and type in your chat room, I've got it. Praise God. Praise God. Yeah, y'all are on point today with the I got it. Yeah, listen. Somebody is wondering what it is that you've got. You got to let them know. I've got the Word of God, and you need to get it for yourself. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11. I'll be reading verses 4 through 11 from the New Living Translation. And this is what the Word of God says. Excuse me. It says, he was buried, talking about Jesus, he was buried and was raised from the dead on the third day. That's today. That's what we celebrate. Just as scripture said, he was seen by Peter and then by the 12. After that, he was seen by more than 500 of his followers at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he was seen by James and later by all the apostles. Last of all, as though I have been born at the wrong time, I also saw him. For I am the least of all the apostles. In fact, I'm not even worthy to be called an apostle after the way I persecuted God's church. This is Paul talking. But whatever I am now, it is all because God poured out his special favor on me, and not without results. For I have worked harder than any of the other apostles, yet it was not I, but God who was working through me by his grace. Let me read verse 4 for you again. Here's what it says. It says, he was buried and he was raised from the dead on the third day, just as the scriptures said. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the application of his holy and righteous word. Listen, I want to put a title to this text and talk about it for the short time that is ours. All rise. All rise is the title of today's message. Listen, I need your prayers this morning. All rise. All rise. Somebody just go ahead and shout that, all rise. You can type it in the chat room if you want to. All rise. Jesus rose from the dead with all power so that you and I could rise from every situation as well, and also arise to have eternal life, a life with him. All rise. All rise. Well, the title of this Easter Sunday message has been heard throughout courtrooms of all sizes and jurisdictions across these United States for centuries. The phrase, "all rise," is an instruction given in a courtroom when the person with the most authority and power enters the room. Come on, somebody. Unless you are physically unable to rise, when a judge enters a courtroom, it is mandatory that when he or she, being the person with power, walks in, everybody has to stand up. Doesn't matter what you're there for. Doesn't matter what's going on in your life. When you hear the bailiff yell, "all rise," or speak the words, "all rise," everybody who is able has to get up. The accused has to rise up. The guilty has to rise up. The innocent has to rise up. The bystanders and the spectators alike all have to rise up when the power enters the room. I'm preaching already. Listen. And on this Sunday morning, on this Easter Sunday morning, it strikes me kind of funny or strange that on Easter Sunday morning, one of the most celebrated religious holidays, that many people are still spiritually, emotionally, relationally, and a few other ways, sitting down or laying down within their negative situations or circumstances in life, loves, and labors. I'm talking about, we know that Jesus Christ rose, and the Bible says he rose with all power. And when he got up out of the grave, and if you believe in Jesus Christ, even if you don't believe in Jesus Christ yet, come on somebody, or the power of Jesus Christ, he still rose for you and I. He rose that you and I could rise up and have eternal life with our Heavenly Father, God. Come on, somebody, when this life is over, but not just in eternal life. Come on, somebody, when Jesus, I'm preaching this thing already. When Jesus rose up from the grave with all power, he also rose something up within us. In other words, he died for our sins. He did something that you and I could not do. He got up, and because he got up, you and I can get up too. Now, I know that things can't be perfect or as we want them to be all the time, but as a believer in Jesus Christ and a child of God, you have more reasons to rise up than you think. Trust me, I get it. There are times, even in my life, that I feel down, want to stay down, hold my head down, or my heart is way down, but I'm here to remind and encourage us today. I'm preaching already that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ died on the cross, was buried in a borrowed tomb, and rose again for our sins. In other words, he got up so we could get up. He was resurrected so we could be resurrected. He arose so we could rise. Rise up. Rise over what, Gary? I'm glad you asked. Rise over your problems. Rise up from your pain. Rise beyond your troubled past. Rise beyond your limited perspective. And he didn't just rise for some of us. He rose for all of us so we all can all rise. Somebody shout out, all rise. Rise! Yeah. Do you understand what I'm trying to help you see? Because the Lord and the Holy Spirit helped me to see it, that when it comes to our courtrooms in these United States, watch this, when the judge who has the power and the authority to make decisions in the life of those in the courtroom walks into the courtroom, the thing you are supposed to do is all rise, because he or she, being the judge, come on somebody, has the power. And when the power enters the room, come on somebody, from wherever it came from, you have to, in the courtroom, all rise. And just like that, even greater than that, come on somebody, when Jesus stepped into your heart, when Jesus steps into your situation, come on, y'all with me, when Jesus comes into your life's courtroom, he comes in with all power, and that means we all rise. Yeah. Somebody needs to go on and shout or type in the chat room, he did it for me. Yeah, Jesus did it for every one of us. And I need somebody under the sound of my voice to understand that we need to stop disqualifying ourselves from the power and the passion of Jesus Christ. He died for your sins. He was buried in a borrowed tomb, and you know anything that's borrowed has to be given back. So, and 3 days later, he got up, but he didn't get up the same way he went down. He got up with all power. And for those of us who have received him in our hearts, and I'm going to even show you, for those of us who have yet to receive him in our hearts, come on somebody, for those of us who are yet living, for those of us under the sound of my voice, he rose for you. So because he rose for you with all power, you you too can rise. Yes, on that great day, if we receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, now watch this. On that great day when this life is over, we can go to live eternally with our Heavenly Father. But also, while we are yet here living on this earth, you have the power through Jesus Christ to rise above, beyond, and through any situation that you might be going through. Somebody yell out, all rise. Yeah. Listen. I get that it can be easy at times to disqualify ourselves from the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. That's called guilt. Sometimes we can do certain things, say certain things, think certain things, or certain things can happen to us where we can look ourselves in the mirror. We've talked about this before. We can look ourselves in the mirror and believe that we do not qualify for the blessings of Jesus Christ. But I gotta let you know, you gotta stop disqualifying yourself from the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. I've been in a space myself, come on somebody, and I've talked to a lot of people that one time or another have felt unworthy or of even thinking that Jesus sacrificed for them because of what they have done or what we have been through. I know you've been through some stuff. I had to let that marinate for a second. We've been through some stuff. Somebody watching me or listening to me right now is going through something very hard right now. And sometimes your mind can shift to the left or the right and not be on the power of Jesus Christ. But I've got to let you know, no matter what weight you think has got you down, the enemy can't keep you down when you have Jesus Christ. You've got to say to yourself, it's time for me to rise. Come on, somebody. But this is exactly what today's message is all about. Just as the death of Jesus Christ was for everyone, so is the resurrection. And today, as we look at 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11, we discover that Jesus rose from the dead for all of us, no matter how we think we may be disqualified. I need you to hold your head up. I need you to pick your heart up. I need you to understand that Jesus Christ rose from the dead for you too. Come on, somebody. He did it for me, and he did it for you. Now get this. He didn't just do it for me because I'm a minister. Watch this. He did it for all of us because we were sinners. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. You didn't want me to get in your business like that. I'm sorry. I understand you that type of person that things just happen to you. You don't just happen to things. Come on, somebody. But listen, the Bible says that all have sinned. That's everybody. That's your mama and them. That's your daddy and them. That's your brother, sister, cousin, uncle, and including you. Come on, somebody. We all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But Jesus Christ, somebody yell out Jesus. Jesus did what we couldn't do for ourselves. He died. He sacrificed his life for you and I. He shed his blood for you and I that it might wash away our sins. And because, I'm saying it again, he arose, you too can rise. So today, I want to share this checklist of you, with each and every one of us, if you will, this checklist of biblical proof that because he arose, we can all rise. What our text gives us today, watch this, what our text, 1 Corinthians 15 chapter verses 1 through 11, gives us today is a list of witnesses to the resurrection. They're people just like you and I who, if we think or our thoughts, our way of thinking, we would think that maybe they were disqualified for one reason or another. But what I am sent here on assignment today to share with us is you and I are qualified as witnesses to the resurrection of Jesus Christ. I find it striking and important for us to see that the resurrection of Christ was for each witness that I'm going to share with you today. It met a need, having a purpose for the witness. Watch this. So what I'm trying to tell you is this. Every person that Jesus showed up to after the resurrection, after he showed himself to after the resurrection, he gave an assignment. And I've got to let you know, you've got an assignment. I know sometimes you think that the Lord can't use me. I messed up. I've done this. I've done that. I said this. I've sinned. I've done this, that, and the third. I'm not worthy. But watch this. I want to share with you today through this message and through this list of witnesses that we all fit to rise as Jesus Christ rose for us. Come on, somebody. It is my sincere prayer that as we study these particular people this morning, you see yourself as having the same need as one of these witnesses. And that means we all rise. So today, here we go. Our text is tailored to teach us that the resurrection of Christ was and is for, first of all, the denier. Somebody say the denier. It's right there in verse 5a. It says he was seen by Peter. But let me give you a little bit more context of the text first. Okay, in our text, the Apostle Paul in this letter to the church at Corinth is really trying to pull them out of their carnal ways and get them more focused on being more Christ-like. In this 15th chapter of the letter, he goes into pointing out how important the resurrection of Christ was and is, but he really begins to put an emphasis on the fact that the resurrection of Christ was not just for a select few. Come on, somebody. It was for everybody. And the witness he points out first is the denier, Peter. Peter. He says it right there in verse 5. He was seen by Peter. So Jesus comes out of the tomb and he shows himself, first of all, to Peter. Peter, who was so adamant about his loyalty before the crucifixion, but he denied Christ three times. Y'all remember that? Listen, you can go back and look at that in Matthew 26, 70 through 74 and Luke 23, 54 through 62. What happened was Peter, at the Last Supper, prior to Jesus being crucified, Peter said, look, Lord, I would never deny you. I love you. As a matter of fact, Peter was so big-headed, watch this, that he even said that he probably loves Jesus more than anybody else. But when Jesus arose from the dead, he appeared to Peter in Luke 24 and 52 and gave Peter some special attention in John 21. I hope you're taking notes because in John 21, Peter the denier needed to know that he was forgiven and still useful in ministry to Christ. Because watch this, Peter denied Christ just like Christ said he would. And I know there's somebody under the sound of my voice and you're saying, well, I would never deny Christ. But you know what? You might not verbally deny Christ. Come on, somebody. But sometimes our sinful nature causes us to deny Christ. Sometimes we are doing, saying, thinking, acting in ways that would represent anything but Jesus Christ. And that's one way that you and I can sometimes deny Jesus Christ. But I've got to help somebody today. That doesn't disqualify you from the blessing. That doesn't disqualify you from being used by God, because Jesus rose from the dead. First of all, we see here for the denier, and that was Peter, but it's also you and I. Because watch this, when Jesus showed himself to Peter, he gave him his reassignment. After Peter had messed up, Jesus still loved him enough, just like he loves you and I, come on somebody, to give him his reassignment. In verse 15 of John 21, he says, feed my lambs. In verse 16, he tells Peter in John 21, he says, shepherd my sheep. And in verse 17, he says to Peter, he says, feed my sheep. You got to understand, what we need to understand is that prior to Christ's resurrection, Peter had boasted. Come on, somebody. Then he denied Christ. He denied knowing Christ. He denied following Christ. He actually fell. And after Jesus showed himself again to Peter, watch this, he was hesitant to boast anymore. He actually didn't know. He no longer had the big head, and he humbled himself now that Jesus Christ had appeared and forgiven him. Jesus gave him the great assignment to lead the churches, come on somebody, and preach the gospel to the lost. Peter had fallen, but Jesus' resurrection for someone like him and for someone like you and me, we can rise again. I know you've been through some stuff. I know you've had some things that maybe you thought disqualified you, but just like Peter, come on somebody, Jesus rose up. First of all, we see here for the denier. Come on, somebody. He rose for the denier. That's why we can sit up here and shout, all rise. Because when Jesus rose with all power, he rose, first of all, for the denier. And that, in some ways, could be you and I. But also, he rose for the denier. But we also see here, the next witness we see here is he rose for the deserter. Yeah. I'm in the text right here. In verse 5b, it says, and then by the 12. Listen. So it says, first of all, he rose and was seen by Peter, the denier. And then he was seen by the 12, the deserters. Get this. The apostles, or the disciples of Jesus Christ, are called the 12, even though they're only now 11 at this time. They were called the 12, and they had run with Jesus in his darkest hour. Jesus appeared to them with the message of peace and commission. In other words, they went and hide. Come on, somebody. They went and hid from those who wanted to point them out as followers of Jesus Christ. When Jesus died, when Jesus was buried, the disciples, the 12, come on somebody, they went and hid out of fear for their life. There were deserters. They were deserters. But listen here, in John 20, 19 and 23, I need you to listen to this. It says, on the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, peace be with you. Are y'all understanding what's happening here? See, the disciples were locked inside of a house. They were hiding from the Jewish leaders. They didn't want to be put to death or stoned. But here comes Jesus giving the picture of him walking through the wall, walking through the door. And he was standing there with them. And he says, peace be with you. And that's a way of Jesus saying to them, I forgive you. I know you were with me when I was here. I know you were with me when I was present in life, but watch this. When I died, you deserted. Come on, somebody. And I don't know if this is speaking a word to you, where sometimes you can have some wishy-washy faith. Come on, somebody. Sometimes we want to follow God. Sometimes we want to praise God. Sometimes we are shouting the roof off. But other times, situations and circumstances can be so hard. Sometimes we want to walk around with our heads down, put hide our crosses. Come on, somebody. Not wear our gospel t-shirts or anything like that. Come on, somebody. Because of what we are going through, and we want to say we are only human. But you know what? We have not been allowed to be deserters. Come on, somebody. And sometimes we might desert Christ. Let me tell somebody, he will never desert you. So here it is. Jesus shows up and he says, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, come on, somebody, I am sending you. So what we see here is this. We see Jesus Christ showing up to the denier and showing up to the deserter. And when he shows up to the deserters, he gives them power as well. Watch this, because in verse 22 of John 20, he says, and with that, he breathed on them and said, receive the Holy Spirit. Don't you understand, my friends, that Jesus loves you and I enough that no matter what we have done, he'll reinstate his power within us to go proclaim his word like he called us to do in the first place? Yeah, all rise. I don't care. It doesn't matter what you've been through. It doesn't matter what you're up against. You too should all rise, because Jesus rose, first of all, for the deserter, but he also rose for the denier. But listen, the text also is tailored to teach us that he also rose for the unconventional. Yeah, or the unconventional or the common. He rose, first of all, so we could all rise. Yeah, he rose, first of all, as a witness, the denier. He also rose as a witness for the deserter. And we could be either one of those. But he also rose, watch this, for the unconventional. The unconventional would be just the common, everyday folk like you and I. And because in verse 6 it says, after that, he was seen by more than 500 of his followers at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Really, what Paul is explaining here to the people is, here was a group of believers who hadn't necessarily denied Christ, and they were not necessarily distinguished people. They weren't disciples, apostles, or anything like that. They were probably an average cross-section of people, unconventional or common, and yet Jesus appeared to them too. Come on, somebody. See, what this part of the text is tailored to teach us is, sometimes we want to disqualify ourselves by saying, I'm just common. I'm just everyday folk. I'm not a preacher. I'm not a pastor. I'm not a minister. I'm not an evangelist. I'm not this, that, and the third. As a matter of fact, I just started going to church. Matter of fact, I ain't even been to church since last Mother's Day or last Christmas. I ain't been to church in a long time. He couldn't possibly have arisen for me. He couldn't possibly want me to rise up out of my situation. Yes, he does. He rose. He rose for the denier. He rose for the deserter. And he rose for the unconventional. this reminds me that one doesn't have to be in a special to be special in the eyes of man to go to heaven, to become saved, and to feel the touch of the resurrection. So maybe you're here and you're thinking now, or have thought in the past, that there's nothing special about me that would make Jesus want to die, be buried, and rise for my sins. There's nothing special about me that would want Jesus to rise up in my situation so I can walk through my problems, so I can walk through my pain, so I can rise up and keep on going in spite of what I am going through. Well, that's a lie of the devil, because the truth is that Jesus died. He was buried and he rose for you and I. And it doesn't mean you don't have to have a title. You don't have to have a tag. He rose for the denier. He rose for the deserter. He rose for the unconventional or common person. And that means we all rise. I'm preaching this thing. I'm trying to get through it. Got two more points. Want to hear them? Here they go. We see here that we can all rise with Jesus Christ because he rose with all power to cover our sins. Come on, somebody. He rose for the denier. He arose for the deserter. He arose for the unconventional. But the next thing we see here in our text is he also rose for the unbeliever. Woo, I'm coming to get everybody today. You see, because there might be somebody under the sound of my voice, and you have yet to accept Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins. You have yet to say, I believe in the power of Jesus Christ. Well, I want you to know something, my friends. If this is you or somebody y'all know, come on, somebody. He arose for the denier. He arose for the deserter. He arose for the unconventional, but he also arose for the unbeliever. And that means we all rise. Yeah, it's right there in verse 7. It says, then he was seen by James. Well, who was James, G? I'm getting ready to tell you. Listen, this James that the text is talking about was Jesus's half-brother. And if you go over to John 7 and 5, it tells us that his brother didn't believe in Jesus as the Christ. He believed he was his brother. Come on, somebody. But he did not believe he was the chosen one. He did not believe he was the one sent by God. He did not believe that Jesus was the Messiah. He did not believe that Jesus was the Christ. And you know what? It makes me think. Ain't it sometimes your own people? Isn't it sometimes the ones that are closest to us that really don't believe in what God is doing through us? Come on, somebody. But listen, if you're here under the sound of my voice, I want you to understand that he arose for the unbeliever as well. Listen, James didn't believe that Jesus was the Christ, but when Jesus arose from the dead, he went and showed himself to James, and James was touched by the appearance of his brother, and he too became a believer. And I've got to share this word with somebody under the sound of my voice. Sometimes, I've said this before and I'll say it again, sometimes you might be the only Bible someone will ever read. Sometimes you might come across somebody who might not believe in Jesus Christ until they can see what Jesus Christ has done through you. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how young you are. It doesn't matter how many times you have fallen because of Christ. Come on, somebody, you can get back up again. Somebody holler out, all rise. I know you're going through some things. I know you might be struggling with your faith or in your beliefs, but Jesus died, was buried, and rose again for you too. And so listen, if you are a believer and you know some unbelievers, you gotta be willing to allow Jesus Christ to rise up in you. Don't talk about people in the negative who don't believe. Don't talk about people who don't worship or praise like you do. Don't look down on people who haven't been to church other than Christmas, Easter, or Mother's Day. Don't talk about people who do things other than what Christians might do, because we all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. And God, come on somebody, and Jesus Christ has arisen for the unbeliever too. Yeah. Somebody say, all rise. Somebody say, all rise, because what I want you to understand is this. No matter what you are dealing with, no matter who you are, no matter what you are going through, Jesus Christ arose with all power for you and I, because we see here in the text, Jesus rose for the denier. He arose for the deserter. He arose for the unconventional or common. He arose for the unbeliever, but he also rose, watch this, for the proclaimers. Yeah. I don't want you to get this twisted, because in verse 7b, it says, and later by all the apostles. What this text, 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11, is showing us is a list, come on somebody, of witnesses who Jesus showed up to. In other words, a list of people who needed to see Jesus right away. And I'm giving you this list of witnesses because each of us, under the sound of my voice, in one way or another, fit into this list. Come on somebody. And what I really want to show you right here is he arose for the denier, the deserter, the unconventional or common, and the unbeliever, but he also arose for the proclaimers, because the text says, and later by all the apostles. In other words, here the text is tailored to teach us that he also arose for those of us, come on somebody, who have been called to preach or proclaim the word of God. In other words, God's messengers. And that's very important for you and I to understand, because I need you to hear me and hear me well. Preachers, pastors, ministers, evangelists, the list goes on. Come on somebody. Can truly do nothing, not even proclaim the word of God, without God. So listen, watch this. This is a message to those of us who have been called, yes, Lord, who have been called to preach, proclaim, and share the word of God in one way or another, that even you, even me, even all of us need the power of Jesus Christ. Yes, I can share the word. Yes, I have been called to preach and proclaim and pastor. Yes, I have studied and learned the scriptures and the text. But watch this. Without Christ, somebody say without Christ, without Christ, without the Holy Spirit, without God the Father, and the power that they impart, we are nothing. That's why Jesus arose for the denier. He arose for the deserter. He arose for the unconventional or uncommon. He arose for the unbeliever, but he also arose for the proclaimers. See, watch this. As the apostles, here in the text, they were sent as messengers with the gospel. The Lord commissioned them to go out in Matthew 28, 18 through 20. I hope y'all are getting these scriptures. In Matthew 28, 18 through 20, he commissioned them to go out and share the good news of the gospel. Because they had seen the risen Lord, they were now effective messengers for him. Come on, somebody. What I'm trying to say is, because he showed up to them, these proclaimers, these ministers, these messengers of God, because he showed up to them, it renewed, come on, somebody, their faith. It renewed their great commission. It renewed their ability to proclaim and preach the word of God. A true witness of Christ, come on, somebody, must see him as risen, or he has no message. Can I say that again? A proclaimer of Christ must see him as risen, or he has no message. I remember growing up, when I was a little boy, I've always loved the crosses. I've always loved cross necklaces. But one time when I was younger, when I was really young, I had purchased a cross in my school store. I went to a private Catholic school. I had purchased a cross necklace. It wasn't anything expensive. It was cheap. And what it had was a cross, but it had Jesus on the cross. It had Jesus on the cross. And I was just so happy and so proud that I had Jesus around my neck. I just wanted to show that I love the Lord, and I believed in Jesus. And I never shall forget this, that I wore it to church or to choir rehearsal or something one weekday night. And I remember one of the associate ministers at the church at the time saying to me, "Oh wow, Gary, that is a really Gary Jr. Little Gary is what they called me at the time. Little Gary, that really is a nice cross, and that's really a nice crucifix you have with Jesus on there. But you do know he got up. You do know he got off the cross. You do know that that's not the end of the story. See, what you're wearing is nice. It looks good around your neck. But what you're wearing, in my opinion, this is what the minister said. I'll never forget it. He said, in my opinion, what you're wearing is just part of the story. He said, what you're wearing is when Jesus was on the cross. Because yes, it had a figure of Jesus with his head down as if he was dying or had died on the necklace. But watch this. He said, you do know he arose. He rose again for your sins. He arose for my sins. And that's what you need to be showcasing. That's what you need to be celebrating. And that's what we need to be sharing. And don't you know? I don't know. Never know what happened to that cross, but I know what happened to me. It changed something within me when I realized that he was not still up on the cross, when I realized he was not still in the grave, when I realized he got up with all power in his hands, and when he got up, I could get up too. And that's why I've got to say, all rise, because Jesus died on the cross, was buried, and rose again for all of us, so we can all rise to be with our Heavenly Father when that day comes. But not only that, we can rise up and beyond any situation we might be going through, because he died, buried, and rose with all power for all of us. Jesus rose, come on somebody, for the denier. He rose for the deserter. He rose for the unconventional or the common. He arose for the unbeliever. He also arose for the proclaimers. But lastly, this text is tailored to teach us is he also arose for the persecutor. The text in verses 8 through 11 says this. It says, last of all, as though I had been born at the wrong time, I also saw him. For I am the least of the apostles. In fact, I'm not even worthy to be called an apostle after the way I persecuted God's church. That's verse 10. And let me tell you what verse 11 says. Verse 11 says this. It says, so it makes no difference whether I preach or they preach. For we all preach the same message you have already believed. What the apostle Paul was sharing right here was this. He was really putting the sealer on this all rise. Because he said, listen, Jesus rose for the denier, the deserter, the unconventional, the unbeliever, the proclaimer, but he also arose for the persecutor. Now get this. We talked about those who didn't believe. But watch this. There were some like Paul at one time when he was Saul. Paul at one time who not only didn't believe, but would go after those who did. Not only did Paul not believe in Jesus, but he persecuted and tried and helped to kill Jesus' followers. Go on and look at Acts 9 verses 1 and 2. The risen Jesus appeared to Paul on the Damascus Road. That's in Acts 9. And changed his life forever. So much so that before Paul had met Jesus on that Damascus Road, before Jesus appeared to Paul in his resurrected state, Paul's name was Saul. The impact Jesus had, come on somebody, on Paul's life of persecution was so great that it changed not just his mindset, not just his spirit, come on somebody, it changed his name. And I don't know who I'm talking to right now, but listen, I'm not calling you a persecutor, but there's some people under the sound of my voice that at one time or another, we've denied Christ in such a way that we've made fun of, come on, maybe not you, but somebody you know, we've made fun of those who want to follow Christ. Maybe you were the one that they made fun of, but can I help you today? Jesus died, buried, and rose again for them too. He died for the deserter. He died for the denier. He died for the unconventional, the unbeliever, the proclaimer, and the prosecutor, but he rose again with all power for all of us. And I've got to let somebody know under the sound of my voice, as I close this message, that you too can rise. I don't know what's got you down right now. I don't know what you're struggling with. I don't know what you've been thinking about lately, but what I do know is that God is calling us through Jesus Christ to all rise. Jesus said before his death that I go to prepare a place for you. Where I go, you shall come also. Watch this. He said to his disciples, just like he's saying to you and I, one day, somebody say one day I'm going to come back to get you. And when I come back to get you, we're all going to be with my Heavenly Father in heaven. But until that day, because I rose, that's what Jesus is saying, because I rose with all power, I impart within each of you the power of Jesus Christ. I know you got some problems. I know you've got some pain. But watch this. Jesus, somebody say Jesus. Jesus is a man of his word. And he died. Woo! Oh, he died. He was buried. Yes, he was buried in a borrowed tomb. And you know anything that's borrowed, you got to give it back. But he rose with all power. And he passes that power on to you. It doesn't matter if you were a denier. It doesn't matter if you were a deserter. It does not matter what you have gone through or done before. Jesus! Jesus! Jesus rose so you and I could rise. All right. In the name of Jesus. All right. In the name of God. All right. By the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Come on, somebody, give God some praise right now. Give him praise because he gave his life for us. He did what you and I couldn't do for ourselves. And on this Resurrection Sunday, isn't it just fitting that we would also celebrate through the partaking of Holy Communion? Listen, this is what I want you to do. I want you to go, if you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I want you to go grab some crackers, some bread, and some juice or some water, because we're preparing for Holy Communion. Jesus died, was buried, and rose again for our sins. But listen to this. Before that, he met with his disciples. 1 Corinthians 11 chapter. Verses 23 through 30 shares with us that this communion experience. And as we prepare our hearts and minds to partake in one of the sacred ordinances of the church, communion, we have to recognize that communion is a time of remembrance. It's a time when Jesus was with his disciples and they were at the Last Supper. And one of his instructions to them was to do this in remembrance of me. And so on this Easter Resurrection Sunday, we want to partake in this communion, and it's because of remembrance, first of all. But you know what? It also should remind us that it's a time of repentance. In 1 Corinthians 11, 28, Paul says that we need to examine ourselves before we partake in communion. If there's anything, any fault we have, we need to ask God for forgiveness. So that's any fault we have against somebody else, anything we're holding against anybody, or maybe even something we think we are holding against ourselves. We need to ask God for forgiveness. So it's a time of remembrance. It's a time of repentance, but it's also a time of a reconciliation. See, listen, Jesus died on the cross, was buried, and rose again to help us reconcile our relationship, come on somebody, with our Heavenly Father. And so likewise, at this time, we should have reconciliation with our brothers and sisters in our hearts and minds. So listen, it's a time of communion, it's a time of remembrance, it's a time of repentance, it's a time of reconciliation, but it's also a time of rejoicing. Yeah, we can rejoice that Jesus did for us what we could not do for ourselves. We just couldn't. And God loved us so much that he would send his only begotten Son to die, be buried, and to rise again with all power. Now, all rise for you and I. So listen, I want you to gather your elements and gather your family or whoever's around you. And I'm going to pray out loud. I want to bless our elements and bless this time. And then we're going to partake in communion. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this time. We thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for Jesus Christ. Father, we pray that you would look inside of our hearts. If there's anything in there that's not like you, please remove it. Please make us better, brighter, bolder, all for your glory. We pray, oh God, right now that you would bless these communion elements. No matter what each individual has to partake in right now, Father, we pray that you would bless them, purify them, God, and that they represent the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, if there's anyone under the sound of my voice who've never received Jesus in the pardon of their sins. I pray that today can be the first day of the rest of their life. I pray, oh God, that that person who may have never received Christ or asked Christ to come into their hearts or may have stepped away from Christ, I pray that they would pray this prayer right now and ask Jesus Christ to come in because they believe, because we believe that he died, was buried, and rose again for our sins. I pray that that person can be blessed and filled with the Holy Spirit. I pray that each of us, under the sound of my voice, can receive the power where we know for sure that you've called us to all rise. Now we pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. So the Bible says that Jesus, on that Last Supper, took a loaf of bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, and he passed it to his disciples, and he told them, this bread represents my body that I'm sacrificing for you. And he commanded them to all eat together. So let us do likewise. Let us all eat together. Amen. Amen. And the Bible also tells us that likewise, Jesus took the fruit of the vine, wine, poured it in the cup, blessed it, passed it to each of his disciples, and he said, drink. This wine represents my blood, the blood that will be shed in remission of your sins. And he said, as often as you will, do this in remembrance of me. So let us all drink together. The Bible says that after this, they all went out singing hymns and praising God. And so listen, I want you to just give God, come on, a hand clap of praise. Give Jesus a great big thank you. Look unto him who has shared and sacrificed all for us. I pray that on this Resurrection Sunday, that you are empowered and encouraged to understand that God has called each of us through his darling son, Jesus Christ, to all rise. Rise up past your problems. Rise up past your pain. Rise up past your limited perspective and see, come on somebody, the greatness of our Father God. He did it for you. He did it for me. He did it for all of us. So let's all rise. Listen, my name is Gary Walsh Jr., pastor and servant leader here at Destiny Church, and we are so grateful to God that you were able to join with us today on this Resurrection Sunday. And on behalf of my beautiful wife, Valencia, and our entire family and our church family, we want you to have a blessed and amazing day and rest of the week on purpose. All rise, go share the goodness of the Lord with somebody else. All rise, let this be the day that you shout out for joy. All rise, in Jesus' name, amen. Take care and God bless. We love you. God bless you. Heaven smile on you. He's a man of his word. Ah, we love you, Destiny. Destiny Church, and we love you. God bless you. Take care. Hallelujah. God bless you. Take care. Have a great day.